I do not have a great BRB. Oh. Of course. Now, when I ended this stream, I wasn't in this position last time. I was actually ended it at downtown. So, what do I have on? Nothing. I looked up where this guy is. The quest that Nox got me. There. Oh, excuse me. Let me just make sure all the things are good. Alerts on alerts. Yep. And yep. Okay, you go do that. And apparently my blood meter is glitched out. Now I practice a bit against this guy, so let's do this. Oi. Good thing I got it. Oh, Jesus, it is crossbow. Ouch. Got him. And now I get, perhaps, basically what the game has the best damaging weapons. Well, almost, considering this weapon is too below. Yeah. I should get firearms up. As well as get a bit. No, wait. Six. Eight. Get some switching up. Time to go to the asylum and be crazy people.
Hey! So, like, how are you doing on that thing we talked about? Oh, cool! You'll be glad once we get this problem taken care of.
I think it's time for me to go downtown for a bit.
Hop in.
Okay, let's go. Downtown! Alright, so there's another thing I looked up, and it's part of this quest, the Regent's Riddle. I did not want to have to go through the part of shoving my brain up my asshole to find out the answers, but we'll find it. It leads to a building with a purple window. I do think I have a quest line on this place. Bloody Skyline Apartments 2A.
Mr. Milton, you know who this is, and I do hope you realize that we're still on for tonight. Meet me at the agreed-upon location across from the bar by the underpass. Bring your associate, Mr. Durbin, as it is a two-man job that I am proposing. With any luck, the two of you are already on your way, and I shall see you soon. Goodbye.
You went to Skyline Apartment. Instead, you heard another message telling Durbin and Milton to meet somewhere on the unknown location across the street from a bar. Okay. So I have an access point. Sweet. That these doors open really slow. Across the street from a bar. So we're loading. Dark blood, our curse, a light to this verse. Where burns the mystical sun? What's this place called? No place. No name. Guess that's it. Minority? Yeah. Why not? What's in here? What? Never been here before. Is this some sort of maze? That's the entrance. Oh.
Greetings, Neonate. Might I assume you received my invitation? I have been looking forward to meeting you for quite some time.
Yeah, I got it. I'm assuming you're...
Strauss. Maximilian Strauss. I am the regent of this chantry. Welcome.
Regent? What's that?
A regent is the leader of a chantry, as well as a teacher to young Tremere apprentices who are studying the mysteries of our clan.
Can you tell me about the mysteries?
I'm sorry, Neonate. The secrets of the Tremere clan are hidden from all but those who share our blood. You would do best not to look into them any further.
Okay, what can you tell me, Max? What's going on here in downtown?
Let me give you some advice, young one. Your survival in kindred society will often depend on your ability to find out yourself what is going on around you. Remember that well.
Appreciate the advice.
As for what is going on here in downtown, the word on everyone's lips, kindred or kind, seems to be epidemic.
What's going on?
It seems that disease has been spreading at an alarming rate throughout the downtown population. Considering our particular appetites, the local kindred are more than concerned about these developments.
Mm. Interesting.
Yes, indeed. My opinion is that the local anarchs are responsible for these outbreaks. Their precipitous indulgence of certain passions often leads to such things. Ergo, their need for the watchful eye of the Camarilla.
Maybe I could look into the epidemic for you.
An interesting proposition. If you succeed in finding the cause of this epidemic and putting an end to it, I will compensate you appropriately for your efforts.
I'll do it. We'll figure out what you want me when I return.
Very well. Again, I recommend speaking with the anarchs. You can find most of them at the local watering hole, reveling in the vices of their former lives. I believe the place is called The Last Round.
I'll remember that. Before I go, can you tell me a little about the Camarilla?
The Camarilla. It is merely a kindred sect that exists to protect its members from the outside world. There are specific codes of behavior that we abide by in order to ensure the continuance of our species. It is nothing more and nothing less.
Woo! All right, I'm out of here. Damn it. I want the exit. I want the fucking exit! Jeez! Okay. Last round, huh? Archway. Oh, God damn it. What's your place? Continue. All I wanted was a bit of blood. That's good. I want to talk to... What's his face on the... the big tap.
I know you're here.
Okay. I guess that's a thing.
Familiar, Chief. We haven't met before, have we? Oh, yeah, back in Santa Monica, right? Whew, I don't know what came over me back there, but now I got this sweet night shift position, and I'm happier than the time I met Superwitz. Ah, well, enough about my lucky break. You, here to see one of the bigwigs, Chief?
Yeah, I'm here to see LaCroix.
Would that be Sebastian LaCroix of the LaCroix Foundation or Dwayne LaCroix of Insurrection Baby Formula Company?
Sebastian.
Okay then. Mr. LaCroix, he told me to expect someone fitting your description sometime tonight. You go right on up.
Thanks.
Yeah, you have a good power meeting, or whatever it is you types do up there. You need any security? Well, you just ring the front desk and ask for Officer Chunk. That's me, in case you were wondering.
Thanks, Chunk. I remember that. Nah, he doesn't do it. Damn it. Jump it. Come on. Yeah. Damn it. Boop. Hey.
What? What?
One more time, but that's good. Can I make you? No.
There you are. I was informed of your presence in the building. Since you're here, I'll take the liberty of assuming you've destroyed the warehouse. This is correct, yes?
Yes, that is.
Most excellent. I had no doubt you'd prove my decision a prudent one. I trust you encountered no impediments to your progress on account of my personnel.
None at all.
That is the answer I like to hear. You've done well, circumstances being what they were. I will admit, not many in your position would have overcome such a trial. But don't misunderstand me. It was no fool's errand. You may yet prove to be a genuine asset. It's a bit disturbing, the lack of talent within this organization as of late. Tell me, what would you say to doing a bit of reconnaissance for me?
What's in it for me?
Don't be so hasty to inflate your own worth. You've succeeded once, very admirable. But in the grand scheme of it all, an infant stride of progress. If you're looking to make a name for yourself, listen very carefully. There have been whispers, rumors spreading around the Kindred community concerning the Elizabeth Dane, the cargo ship that was towed into port recently. Have you heard of it?
No, I haven't. What about it?
The Dane was found out at sea. The reports say it was without crew, but they have yet to report a fate of said crew. The police are investigating the Dane as we speak. Even the Nosferatu have little information on what's been found. However, the reason the ship has caused such speculation is because it was transporting an object called the Onkaran sarcophagus. Now, I'm not one to predicate a decision based on conjecture, so what I need is fact. And more importantly, I need evidence that the occurrences on the Dane were not supernatural in nature, and in no way relate to this Onkaran sarcophagus.
What do you need me to do?
You have three objectives. One, I want you to examine the sarcophagus for anything unusual. You may sense something peculiar about the sarcophagus. In fact, many kindred in the city have reported an uneasiness in the air since the Dane's arrival. Do not, under any circumstances, open the Onkaran sarcophagus. Secondly, the police have begun their investigation. Find out what they have concluded thus far. Thirdly, take the cargo manifest for the ship. I want to find out what else it was carrying. The last thing we want is police aware of our existence, so be careful what you do in front of them. And unlike the warehouse, you cannot wholesale slaughter a ship full of lawmen without consequences. Is this understood?
Uh-huh.
Good.
Oh, and it has come to my attention that you had an encounter with Nines Rodriguez earlier. The man so does love to throw that cretinous charm of his brashly about. What exactly did Mr. Rodriguez say?
He asked me to visit him at the last round.
I see. Then, you should go humor the by-the-numbers rhetoric he's so desperately aching to spew. Oh, please, before the chants of fascist oppressor from that dive of theirs clog the air and choke the local kine.
I'll go see him right away.
Give the Anarch community my regards.
Whatever. No, I'm playing as the Gangreel. A male Gangreel. Gotta be different. Let me guess, you have recently watched Halloween's Let's Play of this, right? Stupid, it's actually right there, number 9. I'm playing as a creature of the evils. Probably because of this helicopter hair. Whee! Bleep, bleep. Time for some ear-wrenching music. I'm not a fan. Let me turn this down a bit. There we go.
Well, well, looky who made it back in one piece. Out in Santa Monica, kiddo.
I didn't get to do much sightseeing.
I can't imagine you did. I've been too busy getting pushed around by every vampire with a week of seniority over you, am I right?
You could say that, yes.
That's usually the way the story goes. Same old bullshit politics from when you were alive. Don't it make you just want to rip somebody's spine out? What? You saying that's just me?
LaCroix is sending me to the Elizabeth Dane.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Why?
The sarcophagus. Did LaCroix tell you about the Ankaran sarcophagus?
Told me enough.
Yeah, well, maybe I should fill you in on the details. That sarcophagus is bad news. Kindred around the globe have been going batshit since it was discovered.
Why?
The word is there's an ancient asleep in there. One of the fathers, one of the vampires, that if you trace your lineage way back, there's a chance it'd end up with him at the roof.
He was asleep this whole time?
Ancients don't just nap. They sleep whole ages away. And when they wake up, they're hungry.
So he'll wake up and go hunting.
It's more than that. Most kindred think it's one of the signs of the end. The apocalypse. Every religion has their own version. Kindred call it Gehenna. And the way they tell it, it starts when the ancients rise to devour their children.
You don't really believe in this stuff, do you?
Well, kiddo, I guess you're gonna be the one to find out. Hey, good luck. Try not to wake Grandpa Munster and kill the world, huh?
Before I go, I wanted to ask you a question.
Sure thing, kiddo. Fire away.
Tell me about the Camarilla.
Oh, my favorite topic.
What do you think of the Camarilla ideals?
Don't think the Camarilla has a monopoly on those ideals, okay, kid? No one is arguing over that shit, and if they tell you that's what this fight is all about, then they're really giving you the full fist. You hear me?
It wouldn't surprise me if they were.
The Camarilla protects the people running the Camarilla. That's it, the end. The rest of them are bloody crystals for the machine.
Who runs the whole thing?
Doddering old dust farts. They might be powerful as all hell, but who knows? They're too afraid to stick their heads out of their hidey holes. Why should they? This whole huge system is built so they don't have to.
Is LaCroix one of the inner circle?
Not one of the bigs, but he ain't out risking his ass in the street, that's for sure. LaCroix has ambitions of joining that inner circle. Delivering Los Angeles in their pocket would look killer on a resume.
Yeah, he definitely wants the corner office.
Ah, to hell with LaCroix. I blasted better vampires' brains all over the wall. He's not the prince. He's a prince.
You've dealt with princes like him in the past?
He's a typical Ventru asshole. Predictable, safe, no imagination. Man, the guy's a pussy. He just got lucky he showed up in L.A. at the right time.
What do you know about the sheriff?
Oh, the sheriff, yeah. I love how everyone's talking about that big mystery. It's like someone embraced a doped-up gorilla.
Did Do you have any problem with the whole Camarilla or just the leadership?
I'm not saying let's go torch the Malkavian living under the abandoned hotel because she happens to be a Camarilla. I'm saying let's change that shit from the top down.
Well, about me, am I the problem or what?
Hey, man, you do what you gotta do to survive when you're young. But there comes a time when that excuse don't apply no more. When you should know better or want to do something about it.
I just wish the facts were easier to come by.
Being dead is no excuse for walking around with your eyes closed.
A few more.
Moving right along.
What about the Anarchs?
That's us, so I'm told. Wouldn't want to know.
How long has the Anarch movement existed?
Yeah, I could tell you about the history of the movement, about our struggle. What's any of that shit mean, anyway? Do we want to sit through history class here?
It's good to know your history.
I'm no scholar, kid, but I've been around. Seen more and done more than most vampires ever will. I don't know that our situation's ever gonna be easy. But some things you gotta decide are worth fighting for.
Maybe does Nines feel the same way?
You bet, kid.
Is he in charge here?
As much as anyone is. Nines is a stand-up guy. Takes the politics a little too seriously. Came up during the Great Depression, so the brain was wired for that shit.
So you're not the chief around here?
Me? I never had much patience for negotiations. Everyone can live or burn, except for them.
What about the rest of Nine's crew?
Yeah, I'm not sure the story on most of them. Nine's crew.
What clan is Nine?
Bruja. Most everyone here has Bruja blood.
See ya. Wait.
So I heard you and Nines had a run-in with the Sabbat, huh? And you let them go. Nines must be getting soft. How could you pass up that kind of fun?
Chat. How do you think the Sabbat found me?
Someone must have put a word out. Now, here's an interesting little scenario. I'm just gonna run this by you, see what you think. What if the prince got the word out to the Sabbat that you were the one to blow up their warehouse?
You really think that's possible?
Hey, it's a theory, man, but who else is going to be watching you so closely, knowing where you're going and all that?
That's a good point.
That's how the Camarilla works, kiddo, trust me. I've been dealing with these slimy shits for a few centuries now.
That's why I call it dirty politics.
Politics. The stuff that makes the rich get richer, keeps the powerful in power. Look at why you're out in Santa Monica in the first place. Because Prince LaCroix said so.
Alright, but why me?
Because he never thought you'd make it back. If Nines didn't stand up for you in the courtroom, you would have been toast right there, man. Everybody knows that.
How did Nines make a difference?
Public relations, man. Calculated risk. Venture are born in a boardroom. When Nines called him out, LaCroix realized it was time to show a carefully measured dose of Camarilla compassion.
You're not into public relations, Jack.
Yeah, man. It's called kicking ass and crushing the skulls of any asshole who steps on my toes. That seems to work.
Is LaCroix afraid of Nines? I thought he was the boss.
LaCroix is the boss of the Camarilla in L.A. That's it. LaCroix is the boss. That's rich.
Yeah. You don't follow Camarilla law?
kid, I never answered to no man in life. Now I sure as shit ain't taking orders from a vampire with a suit and a funny name. And when I die again, the devil's gonna have to cut me a deal if he wants my ass. Besides, I never trust anybody with an X when I aim.
Huh. I think LaCroix's got a little man syndrome.
The facts are like this. The Camarilla need us to buy into their bullshit for any of the laws to be dick. Now, telling free-living vampires they need to be ruled is a hard sell. So, the Camarilla baked up a play nicey plan. Show everyone how great they are, so we'll all just jump on board.
Not working?
Kid, we've lived in California, some of us, for over 100 years, and we've kicked the Camarilla's ass out of town before. Seems like every time they smell blood, they're back trying to take over.
What? Crushing the balls of any asshole in my way? Huh. Got a few more questions.
Sure thing, kiddo. Fire away.
Tell me about the Sabbat.
The Sabbat are worthless, man. Fake tits on a zombie worthless. Fun to watch, though. Like the Three Stooges with chainsaws.
They're anti-Camarilla?
Yeah, they're opposed to Camarilla, but they suck when it comes to execution.
But all of them?
The Sabbat are in the same business as the Camarilla. Sabbat have a little longer chain, but they're slaves all the same.
Yeah, I guess. Later.
Well, if it ain't the talk of the town, host a child for Camarilla Benevolence. What errand does the prince have you running today, boy?
Funny. Is Nines Rodriguez around here?
Nines is expected. Have some manners and don't wear out your breath.
Yeah, all right. You got a few minutes to talk?
What's up?
None of this vampire shit makes any sense to me.
You've got to understand, Kendrick. You're carrying a 6,000-year curse in your blood. No matter how powerful it makes you feel.
Curse?
That blood is a tangle of chains that's going to leave you bound in servitude the rest of your existence.
You think so?
Your elders command the blood. They control the blood, and the blood listens. You'll never even hear their call, but the blood will, and it'll make you obey.
How can you break free?
That shit stretches all the way back to Cain, man. Nothing you can do. Some ancient sleeping in a tomb half a world away has a bad dream, and you gon' feel that shit. Like it or not.
Who's Cain?
Cain, man. Father of all vampires. Killed his brother Abel and was cursed by God to walk eternity feeding on the blood of his children. Some heavy shit, man.
You don't really believe that, do you?
Keep your voice down. Is Cain real? I don't know. Not sure I want.
I hear you, but where are you going with this?
The point is, with this curse pulling your strings, you really want to sign away your right to fight by joining the Camarilla?
What have you against the Camarilla?
The Camarilla just ain't necessary. Their rules is just common sense shit. Masquerading. Sure, it makes sense. Like the Ten Commandments. More than Ten Commandments.
Sure.
Yeah, thou shalt not steal, thou shalt not kill. Sounds good, but you won't be voting the way you don't always have. What if some society like the Camarilla comes along and just up and kills you if you break one damn commandment?
I see your point.
See, we weren't meant to live like that. Not follow someone else's rules for 3 years.
You're talking too quiet!
But it wasn't until after the embrace that I understood real oppression.
Thank God for subtitles! So the Anarchs are the way, huh?
Anarchs? We are the only ticket to free living in the afterlife.
You agree with the masquerade?
I don't need to bare my fangs to feel good about myself. Masquerade is a fruity Camarilla label. Other than that, I ain't got no problem with you. Live and let live. We got enough to worry about.
Amen.
You know, speaking of the masquerade, I just thought of something you might be able to help us out with.
Tell me about it.
There's this girl who's been making a lot of noise lately. You're a pain in the ass. She's a ghoul of this one Toreador creepy disappeared.
What's her name?
Her name's Pat. She hangs out at the clubs downtown. She used to show up around here and act like she was everybody's best friend. It was all fun and games until that vampire sugar daddy stopped calling. Now she can't get her blood fixed and she ain't so fun no more.
Doesn't she understand he's gone?
Man, she's been told he was dead. She don't listen. Just ask again louder. She's gonna make a scene and get us all some real heat.
What do you want me to do?
She's crossed the line. The only time that mouth ain't blabbing is when it's sucking vampire blood. She's gotta disappear. Do this, and we'll keep our little secret here.
Anything for my...
Yeah. All right. Have fun. I'd love to do this one myself, but I know it's silent. Just let me know when it's done.
I'll find her and take care of it. See ya. Okay, so there's a quest. You have a quest.
What did you just say?
Is what I said.
You showed up. Good. Here's what I gotta tell you. And so you know, I don't lecture, I don't rap, I'm no bureaucrat. I'm just a guy out of nowhere came to be involved in something 500 times bigger than you and me.
Ooh. Not another goddamn speech. Go on.
You got a right to know the score. The Camarilla, this is the short of it. They operate a lot like a pyramid scheme. There's a bunch of these old timers at the top with God only knows what plots in mind. They lose their power, they die. They sired more to carry out their plans, and looking for a little power than those kindred sired for their own schemes, and so on and on and on. It hurts my head just thinking about the mess. What it works out to is this. Only a few people at the top have any real power.
Aren't you a part of the Camarilla?
Them's fighting words, newbie. But you're young and stupid, so I won't make an example out of you. See, the Camarilla claims all of us are members, even if we don't want to be, which is... course, the biggest little horseshit a man ever heard.
If only I have a voice slider to increase your voice volume. So why are you all about it?
I learned the way of this world during the Depression. A bunch of old rich bastards screwed the country. But did they suffer? No. The little people suffered. You can't trust the people at the top. The world would be a better place without them. All you can do is get a group of people together who aren't assholes. Find a place to put your feet up and make some examples of the quote-unquote elite. Keep the rest the hell out. Everyone's an equal here. The same thing this country used to be about. That's what LA has been. An anarch-free state.
So the Camarilla is new to LA.
The Camarilla was kicked out on the ass a long time ago. We anarchists didn't want to play the politics anymore. Now LaCroix and crew pop in like they never left. No goddamn way. Their laws don't apply to us.
Not a fan of the Prince, huh?
LaCroix represents everything I hate. The Camarilla, stuck-up aristocrats, rich businessmen, crooked politicians. The only place LaCroix belongs is in an urn.
Have you tried meeting with the Camarilla?
I got their meeting right here.
Okay, that was random. The patch added that in. So, sounds like you're the Prince of the Anarchs.
No such thing. And again, newbie, don't throw those kind of words around lightly. We're risking a beatdown. I fought to keep L.A. free since I was embraced. A long time later, I'm one of the only ones left that hasn't bid or switched sides. The most veteran soldier in the battle.
Any advice you can give me?
Here's what I tell all the new blood. One, you get careless, that blood will make you into a monster. But you rampage around here, you get put down. Two, don't kill when you feed. no reason to. In this city, there's lots of ways to slake the beast without leaving a trail of dead. 3, the Camarilla's full of shit. 4, watch your back, always. And lastly, learn how to fight. Because a speech ain't gonna save your ass when you're staring down the barrel of a shotgun.
Thanks for all the help.
L.A.'s the school of hard knocks, so keep your friends close and your enemies in the barbecue pit. Once you square things with LaCroix, don't give that son of a bitch the time of night. I got my eye on you, kid.
Okay. Alright, one more kid to talk about.
Y'all get me a quest!
So that chase you in here, Cammy? You guys are all the same.
Why do you ask?
Heard 9 saved your ass again. You think LaCroix would have stopped counting his money long enough to get your back, Jack?
What the fuck's your problem?
Oh, you want to know what my problem is? Alright, I'll tell you what my problem is. You ready? You are my goddamn problem. Anyone who would lay it down for some cape in an ivory tower deserves what they get.
I make my own fate.
That's real. Let me put it in perspective for you. The Camarilla claims every kindred's part of the organization regardless. You do something they don't like, well, you're Camarilla, so you get punished under their laws, like it or not.
Enlightening.
I'm Damsel, grandmother of these mothers, and one pissed bitch since LaCroix ruled in.
Alright, let me read the options. Give me a moment. Oh. I'm being distracted by phone.
Oh no!
It's a comment on YouTube, aren't you? Well, a reply to my comment. Okay. Guess you don't see.
Don't even joke about bad blood at a time like this. Don't you know we've got a plague bearer around here?
Plague bearer?
A plague bearer is a thing that doesn't care who they feed on. Yeah, I know what you're thinking. You can't get sick, but the kind can. And kindred that feed on them start spreading disease. And if they get sick, it's an epidemic. CDC's in town as we speak.
Sorry, I picked one. So how do you get rid of one?
See an old yeller? May sound cruel, but it's necessary. If someone puts together 2 and 2 as to the real cause of an outbreak of bloodborne diseases, guess what happens?
So
the plague bearer's gotta be found and put down. If the Camarilla really gives a damn, they'll help us out.
I'll do it, well, but only because I'm bored.
One of our boys, Ghouls, name's Pop, lives nearby in the Skyline Apartments. What a stranger lately. Looked like death last time he was here. Said he didn't get bit, but maybe you can get more info out of him.
I'll go check it out.
Wait, if Paul's not talking, you might want to start questioning the homeless Pop. So many have been dying lately that it takes the city a few days to pick up the bodies.
I'll ask around right now. Bye, Damsel. No, we're out of the annoying music. I really. Okay, we got some new quests from a past month. Attention to us. Go to once. Make Petty disappear. She's a ghoul who's bugging everyone about her master. Club of Confession. Ah, being cuddled. Number 5. Apparently doing this makes it go faster, so... But guess what? Let's go even faster. I know it's cheating, but... Billy, do you want me to run... all the way around? Now where is he? There he is. Persuasion. Oh shit. Godzilla. Wait!
Player, what's the score? How they hang? Good evening and all that commotion. Welcome to Fat Larry's Trucker Mac, the only store for all your needs after 10 o'clock. I am the proprietor and salesman of the month several years in a row. The ladies call me, oh God, but you can call me Fat Larry with a F-A-T, because I know I got a weight problem. I just don't give a fuck.
You saw a counterfeit basketball jersey or something?
Counterfeit? Man, I look like one of those peanut-headed, rock-smoking brothers selling S-H-A-C-K shirts they made at their mama's house. I'm the real deal OG man in the alley with what you need. Counterfeit. Man, why you gotta be like that?
Alright. Why don't you show me what you're selling?
Nah, that's what I like to hear. But it's like this. I save my best stuff for select clientele. Now, that don't mean I don't appreciate your business. It's just, you know, business.
Show me the merchandise.
Yo, koala ears, lazy eye hammocks, and dwarf saddles right here. Oh, man, got a Galapagos turtle this week only. Yo. Yo, I got...
Say now, brother. Seeing the kind of commando gear you been stocking up.
Yeah. Whoops. You ain't just your nerves, Joe, for giving your neighbors away from your shit, is you? So.
Well, that's your business, okay? I just figured somebody with a shopping list like yours might be up for a little action, Zar. Alright?
I'm listening.
Yo, I need a hardcore, massively bionic, two-fisted Yo Jimbo for a supersized skull. Straight up $100 million movie gangster. You still with me?
Yeah, you've got my attention.
Here's what's going down. I got a tip that the Chinatown Tone and some local boys I meet down at a nearby parking garage to carry out a business deal. Now,
business.
I can't tell you what they is exchanging, but let's just say a certain client of mine is ready to drop some Uncle Sam-sized bucks to acquire what's in briefcase number one. You get it for me, I'ma not only give you a cut, but I roll out my special stock as well. Now, how that sound?
Sounds like a good deal for you. I want a discount on at your store as well.
Yo, man, why you gotta shake me down like that? If I hadn't just got my foot out of cash, I'd do it myself. But, yeah, it's got to be that way. Fine. You got a discount. But only after I get the briefcase.
Deal. I'll do it.
Yeah, that's what I like to hear. Now, if you're the straight-out hard-boiled Terminator type, I'd suggest you buy some heavy firepower before you roll up to the parking garage. You need anything?
Let's see what you get.
Check it out. Step right up. Yo, I got dinosaur eggs. We don't know what kind. Buy them and hatch them. David Duchovny Sink. Signed, sealed, and certified. Hey,
walk
on by. I look like Dionne Warwick.
I know I'll get a discount, but I'm going in combat style. I'm going to need all I can use. Yeah. Still got the wonky hair. Wait, no, this is this spot. Only reason I want to do this is just to make the traveling a bit quicker. This way. Combat style, bitches. Four. There we go. Should have used blood heal.
Thank you.
There we go. Yes, ouch indeed. Game's not easy. Ah, shit. This might have been a bad idea. Wait for them to come around the corner again. No. Surrounded. Don't have a lot of blood. Well, need to eat. Alright, he's dead. I'm going to eat the last one. Come on. There we go, finally. And I'm good to go. There we go, finally. In plain sight. I died multiple times. Now time to be an act fighter. Yeah! 1 experience point. Pass out, you pass out. Nothing wrong with that.
Outstanding! Pass it over here, partner. Yeah, that's beautiful. Everything looks in order. Somebody somewhere got to be pissed off about losing this. Too bad I sent my man right here after. All right, let me peel off a few bills for you, and I'll give you a discount from now on. I'll just drop this off to the new owner in the morning. Then I'm gonna get me a big old steak. Not that domestic stuff neither. I'm gonna order 32 ounces of Kobe beef, the expensive shit. You wanna come? My treat.
I'll have to pass. I'm unavailable during the day.
Say, my girl down at Confession, named Venus Dare. She asking around for someone with skills to... Well, I'll let her tell you. I'll give her a call, recommend you if you're interested.
Yeah, I'll check it out. But first, I need to buy some merchandise.
Man, what you do with all this stuff, I don't want to know. Just keep that cash flowing.
I will, Levy.
Yo, man,
got a Galapagos turtle. This week only.
It's not discounted.
Signed, sealed, and certified.
Now I would buy this gun, but yeah.
Yo, yo, yo. Koala ears, lazy eye hammocks, and dwarf saddle. Right here. Only. Yo, man. Got a Galapagos turtle. This week only. Yo, yo, yo. I got dinosaur eggs. We don't know what kind. Buy them and hatch. Yo, man. Got a Galapagos turtle. This week only.
He's saying the same thing over and over and over.
Hey, don't walk on by. I look like Dionne Warwick. Check it out, check it out. Step right up. Yo, yo, yo. Koala ears, lazy eye hammocks, and dwarf saddles. Right here, only here.
I thought they didn't have this thing here. Yeah. Alright.
To me. I swear you were all, like, totally drawn to me. I'm surprised I don't know you. I usually meet all the L.A. vampires out on the scene. Not a lot of you out tonight, which
heck?
Is weird, because I don't know of any parties going on.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
No, come on. It's totally cool. I'm Patty. Seriously, everyone knows me. Besides, I just wanted to ask you if you've seen someone.
Okay.
His name is Kent Allen Ryan. He's a toreador. Really good looking. Dresses really well. Like all Prada, usually.
I do know him. I saw him recently.
You are totally awesome. Just goes to show you that you don't have to dress cool or have a lot of power to be a cool person. So, where is Kent?
He went to San Diego for some business deals he had to act fast on.
Oh, that is totally Kent. He's so like that. I better go find him. He needs my help to do anything. Thanks again.
Yeah, no problem. Just drive down there. He'll be working for you. Okay, no masquerade loss. Alright, L.
Everybody comes in here's got to have a shot. House rules. Inhibition's the first thing to go. Two more of these and you'll be telling me your nastiest, dirtiest stories. I am your beat priestess, and it's time to confess.
Who are you?
Venus was her name. Got anything you want to confess?
Larry mentioned me.
Larry? Oh, so you're the Action Jackson he was going to send over? Oh, yeah. I've been waiting for someone like you to come in here. You see, I've got this situation that's gotten a little out of hand, and I need someone to inform some people that they won't be getting paid this month. Intrigued yet?
Intrigued? Go on.
Well, the parking lot next to the Empire Hotel. Couple of guys, Russian accents, bit thick. I need you to tell them Venus doesn't have their money. That's it.
That's it?
That's it.
What's in it for me?
Drinks on the house. For a week.
I'd prefer cash.
You want cash? Whatever, I can do that. Question is, are you worth it?
Definitely. I'll do it.
I expected you'd bite. Empire Hotel. Tell them I'm broke. You can run, right? Never mind. Just don't go starting any street fights, alright? These guys are connected. Anyhow, a lot of people have yet to confess to the beat freezers. Later, darling.
Back in a minute.